हेलो स्टूडेंट, दिस इज़ मी सौरभ अवस्थी, फैकल्टी ऑफ माउ लिट्रा जी स्कूल. इन अ प्रीवियस वीडियो आई गेव यू द समरी ऑफ द लेसन द पोर्ट्रेट ऑफ अ लेडी रिटन बाय कुशवंत सिंह. नाउ इन दिस वीडियो, एज आई टोल्ड यू इन प्रीवियस वीडियो दैट आई एम गोइंग टू गिव यू सम क्वेश्चन आंसर्स फॉर दिस चैप्टर. सो इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू रीड अबाउट grandmother, that means about the character sketch of grandmother, and then we will go through 9 questions which I have given for you, which you have to read and you have to learn, and also you have to write them in your fair copy. Okay, so let's begin. Here grandmother was an old and short lady. Her face was covered with wrinkles. She always wears white dress and take beads of rosary in her hands. She was a polite and kind lady. She was a very religious woman. When narrator lived with her in village, she always feed dogs with stale chapatis, but after coming in city, she was unable to feed dogs with chapatis because in city there were no dogs. But when narrator went to abroad for his further studies, she felt very sad. Now, she spent most of her time by spinning at the wheel and praying. She feed the sparrows in her spare time. When she feed the sparrows, they sat on her head, hand, etc. and start chirping like they are talking with her. And also, she cannot help the narrator in her studies because she don't know about science and English. She was sad to hear that there was no teaching about God and scriptures in narrator's school. She also think that music was not meant for gentle folk. Okay, when the narrator came from the abroad, she felt happy and collect all the women of her neighborhood and start singing the homecoming of warriors. Due to overwork, she developed fever. She told her family members that her end was near, but the doctor said she would recover soon. She don't spend time with her family members. Instead, she continued praying till she breathed her last breath. So this was about the character sketch of the old lady who is grandmother of the author. So now let's begin with the NCERT based question and answers. Let's begin with the first question. Mention the three phrases of the author's relationship with his grandmother before he left the country to study abroad. So I am going to tell you in brief about the answer. That in the first phrase, it has been given the period of his early childhood where he used to live with her in the village and they had a good friendship with each other. In the second phase, the author and his grandmother sniffed to the city as the author's parents settled well in the city. Third phase, you can see the author went to the university. He was given a room of his own. This made their friendship bond weaker as the common link between them, the same room, snapped. So now the next question is, mention three reasons why the author's grandmother was disturbed when he started going to the city school. So students, here again we can see 3 points which are given in the answer, that she was no longer could help him in his lessons. As he started going to the English medium school, this became a barrier for her. And in second point, you can see there were no teachings about God and the scriptures. And the third point, she didn't like him taking the music lessons because according to her, music was only for beggars and harlots. So now the third question is, mention three ways in which the author's grandmother spent her days after he grew up. The answer is, His grandmother changed a lot since he grew up. She would spend her day at the spinning wheel, chanting prayers and feeding sparrows, which gives her lots of happiness. Okay, now question number 4. Mention the odd way in which the author's grandmother behaved just before she died. So students, in this story, when you must have read about the summary, you must have seen that when the author was coming back, grandmother became so happy that she brought a drum and called her neighborhood women, and then she started homecoming of the warriors. That means she started singing songs. And then the next day, she fell ill. She said her and was near. She started praying peacefully while laying on her bed. She refused to talk to anyone during her last hours. So this was the incident just before she died. Okay, now the question number 5. Mention the way in which the sparrows expressed their sorrow when the author's grandmother died. So answer is, students, the grandmother used to feed the sparrows in her veranda each day. But on the last day when she was dead, they didn't cheer up and there was complete silence. The author's mother tried to feed them by breaking the bread and throwing it in front of them, but they didn't eat anything. When the family carried grandmother's corpse, they all flew away quietly. So this was the incident of the last day when grandmother was dead. Now, the next question. The author's grandmother was a religious person. What are the different ways in which we come to know this? So here also, students, she used to visit the temple when she used to leave the child to the school. Then she used to read scriptures. Then she used to chant her prayers and her hand remained busy in telling the beads. So when the author went to study at the university, she went into seclusion and spent her whole day in chanting prayers. So like this, she used to spend her whole day. Okay, now the question number 7. This is very lengthy. So students, I am just reading the question for you. You can read the answer given over here and then you can make your own answer in your own words, which you have to write in your fair copy. So the question is, describe the changing relationship between the author and his grandmother. Did their feelings for each other changed? So here I am just reading the conclusion part of this answer, the last para, which you can see, no, their feelings for each other didn't change, but during the time a distance developed between them. Okay, so that means the gap was maintained but the relation was not, that means changed. Okay, so now the next question, question number 8 is, would you agree that the author's grandmother was a person strong in character? If yes, give instances that show this. So here, student, the answer is, yes, the grandmother was a strong person in character. The instances are as following. She had her own thoughts about the schools and their teachings. She didn't like music, as according to her, music was for low-level people. The third point is, she used to chant prayer, tell beads and feed bread and crumbs to the sparrows. She used to feed dogs with steel chapatis and she used to spend her whole day in chanting prayers. And also at the last time, she didn't want to waste any time talking to anyone, so she kept on chanting prayers till she died. So this was grandmother. Now, which language do you think the author and his grandmother used while talking to each other? Answer, The author and his grandmother used to talk to each other in their mother tongue. As the author belongs to Punjabi state, they would talk in Punjabi language. So students, these were your question and answers which you have to learn and write in your fair copy. Okay, now stay safe, stay healthy, and thank you so much.